Alrighty, time for round three. I'm on the draw. Yeah, that sounds fine. A little two laner on the draw with all four drops, but I've got a one drop, and that one drop will survive for a while. Opponent's also mulliganing to six. Also, aim high does mean that I'll have other interaction. Oh, never mind. We're dead. We are dead. We could just scoop him up when my opponent plays land number two here. I'm just not going to beat a Crypt Breaker. They're just going to make a zombie, then make another zombie, then make another zombie, and then that'll pretty much be that. I think I'm supposed to attack. All right, so we'll see what happens here, but I think that I'm going to be hard pressed to win. I could take, I'll just take Tattered Haunter, I guess. Could take Shrill Howler because it does get past all those zombies. Maybe that's just, I have to take that even though it's a little riskier. But Prized Amalgam? What am I playing against? This is like the deck that my team played at the last Pro Tour. Well, except I played Bant, because Bant is great. All right, well, we're done here. I'm not even making a good play. My opponent's going to be able to draw a card. Yeah. All right, well, this could be a fast one. We'll see. All right. Oh, I'd like to play first. This hand is a little less exciting. I'm going to keep it. Look, Overworld of Mysteries is great in this deck. I've got a lot of low-drop creatures that if I draw them, this hand becomes good. And I can Fortune's Favor into great stuff on turn four. I mean, like, I'm just never beating a turn one Crypt Breaker. Not in a million years. Like, there's just no, I don't have a way to remove it. There's just no way that this is happening. Wailing Ghoul. Okay. Right. Land. Play Mysteries. Gonna play Stitchwing Scob next turn. I mean, this isn't Pack Rat, but the fact that it just means that my opponent draws extra cards and makes a creature every turn is gonna make it really hard to, for me to end up winning. No attacks with either of them. Interesting. All right, let's play Stitchwing. I mean, maybe I can assemble a squad of flyers or something. Is my opponent going to discard Adjust the Wind? Because that would just be... Okay. Good. So next turn, I'm like... Oh, and they have Borrowed Malevolence to kill my... So next turn, I was hoping I was going to get to attack for some damage. So right now my opponent could make a third zombie and then draw a card. They could just immediately draw a card and then play a four drop. They didn't play anything this turn. Interesting. And there's a Lash Weed Lurker. Okay. Let's try to win this game. We're not out of this. I can't bring back Scob and play Lash Weed Lurker. So let's just go. Just stack a clue to draw a card. Make a human. Draenyard Behemoth. Let's just make a Tattered Haunter. And pass. Where's my opponent? They didn't do anything with their mana. Okay. I think I'm in trouble, but this is not... I'm not just dead. So now I get to attack with Tattered Haunter. What I need to do is start getting big creatures into play so them drawing a bunch of extra cards is not as good. Easier said than done, but that's my plan. And I chose to play Tattered Haunter over returning Stitchwing Scott because I didn't want to discard Fortune's Favor or Aim High. Alright, what does my opponent got? Geralt's Masterpiece? They just kind of have it all. Alright, well, let's cast with Emerge, sacking Tattered Haunter. Pay five, Mysteries, Masterpiece, use Lash Weed Lurker's ability, hit my opponent for one, and opponent can play Masterpiece, it'll be a 3-3 still. They can just play a land and say go. They have the ability to tap three zombies and draw a card pretty much at any point here, but I'm not sure if they are looking to do that. They haven't missed a land drop, but they already milled two lands and discarded a land, so we'll see what they're up to in just a second. I might be able to set something up where I'm like, aim high to make Lashweed Lurker win a combat, bring back, no, I don't have enough mana to bring back Stitchwing Scob and then sack it to Id of the Horrid Swarm. That's just not quite going to work. I do get a one mana discount if I emerge off of the human soldier, since the emerge costs are both one cheaper than the base cost. Alright, Masterpiece coming down, no land getting played. Interesting. What am I do, like, the block with, like, Wailing Ghoul and Masterpiece, and then I get to aim high. I might have to find another Lashweed Lurker to take down the Masterpiece once it comes back. Alright, I don't want to sack a clue yet. I'm just going to attack with Lashweed Lurker. Offer some kind of trade, or just get some damage in. There's no blocks. Okay. That's fine. Got a 12. I really would like to hit a land drop. God, this is tough, because if I sack the clue and don't draw the land, I don't really like the position I'm in. But I guess I'm at 19. I can afford to take a hit, and this makes a soldier, so it's just really important I get lands into play here. Drenau, Quartz Trawler. Yeah. Alright, let's just pass the turn. Now I'm definitely bringing back Stitchwing Scob. Alright, draws a card. Masterpiece goes to 2-2. If only I had a bounce spell, god, that'd be so sick. If end of turn I just like bounced Crypt Breaker, and then opponent drew for a turn and draws Masterpiece, just died. It's also cost, what, 4 to bring back? Yeah, 4 cards. I could also, if they attack with Masterpiece, I could aim high and untap, or no, they're discarding, okay. They're discarding a Madness card. They have Adjust the Wind. God, this really is the deck that we played at the Pro Tour, which is bad probably for your Pro Tour chances, probably good for your limited chances. All right. Unfortunately, I have too many Emerge creatures in hand right now. It's actually not working out great for me. They have an Asylum Visitor. Well, we both have millions of cards in hand. All right. I do like them attacking. I'm actually really close to winning the game with this Stitchwing Scob. Definitely going to be getting this one into play. Alright, and discarding Fortune's Favor. I could discard Drenau, Corpse Trawler. I could discard one of my Emerge creatures. I think Drownyard Behemoth is the worst one right now. And because right now I can do 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 damage in the air, so it's not enough. Hinterland Locker, well, you're useless. I'm definitely attacking with Stitchwing. Really wanted to land at some point, because now I can play Hinterland Logger. Yeah, actually, I just play Hinterland Logger, which is not a really exciting turn, but the reason I want to do that is I can set up trades, make mysteries, and then next turn I can sack it to Drolf's Masterpiece. Or to put Drolf's Masterpiece back on top with Lashweed Lurker. I don't want to put the Masterpiece back on top quite yet. Opponent's on 7. Also, Stitchwing is lethal except if I have 6 mana untapped, which I guess I'm not going to. Alternately, I could have played last turn It of the Horrid Swarm off Stitchwing and then left mana up for Stitchwing. It may have been better. Let's see what my opponent's got here. They've got a bunch of zombies. Laboratory Brute, okay. And they milled Grizzled Angler and Cemetery Recruitment, sure. Wailing Ghoul, okay. Yeah, I do have a lot of ground creatures. If they attack with Drolf's Masterpiece, I just get to kill them, but I don't think that's gonna happen. I have to attack with other things, right? No attacks. Okay. I guess that's fine. I'll take my turn. And let's go Lashweed Lurker, Drolf's Masterpiece, attack you. And then attack my opponent to 4. And put them in a position where they aren't getting a draw step, and I mean, they can still use the Crypt Breaker, but I don't know if that's gonna be good. Because, right, alright, I guess Stitchwing Scob is now lethal without any combat tricks. The problem, wow, they're just going deep on that. I don't know, that's pretty risky. Now the Drolf's Masterpiece is just gonna be smaller, though. Like, you play a land and recast Masterpiece and end up with, I guess, a 3-3, but I think this might be, somehow, I might be doing okay here. If I could give a creature trample, I would win very easily. But we're not at that point yet. And or ever, because I don't have any way to give trample. But I do have a bunch of ways to make creatures in my hand. Watch on the web can also buy me a lot of time. So I played the Swamp. I guess they can also play Masterpiece and then discard a card to Cryptbreaker and then it'll become a 4-4. And a 4-4 is reasonably sized. Let's see. This Stitchwing Scob is doing a lot of work, I'll tell you that much. Going into one and tapping three creatures in it. What just happened? Why did I win? Okay, I'll take it. Thought I was just stone dead there. Okay, well. Okay, my opponent's had turn on Cryptbreaker twice. Can we just not have that happen the third time? I feel like that's more than fair. Alright. Alright, we may have found a hand that's so bad that I won't keep it. This hand doesn't even have the good long-term possibilities of mysteries, so let's go ahead and mulligan. This hand is much better. Opponent mulligan to 6 as well. I guess if my opponent's aggressively mulliganing into Cryptbreaker, that's one thing. I'm going to put a land on the bottom. If I draw a land, that's fine. Yeah. Oh, they didn't have it. I just assumed they did. If I draw a land, that's fine, but I'm not putting a land on top because I don't want to draw two lands. Graph Rats, okay. Just get Tattered Haunter into play, start chipping away. Prized Amalgam. Well, it is a 3-mana 3-3. But it is. Another land isn't great. I really needed a 3-drop so I could put It of the Horrid Swarm into play. But I guess I'll have to wait a turn on that. Alright. Yeah, I'm going to take the damage. I feel like trading for Graph Rites isn't good when I want to sack this to It of the Horde Swarm. And if I brick on my turn, if I just draw a land, I can just pass and like flip Hinterland Logger, and then that's also reasonable. Oh, my opponent has no plays. Okay. I like that. Yeah, let's just get in there. Oh, just the wind. Okay, well, that's fine too. Let's play the Hinterland Logger. Next turn, I can Eat of the Horrid Swarm it. I could use Aim High to trade for the Graph Rats. I just don't care about Graph Rats here. So I think this is fine. Wailing Ghoul, sure. There goes your Crypt Breaker. How's that taste? Now I get Exultant Cultist. Sure. Plus, not trading for Graph Rats is good because the insect tokens just deal with Graph Rats so easily. Tattered Haunter. Well, that looks like a card I'll want to aim high. Play Mysteries and attack with Tattered Haunter. I guess they could just not block, but then I'll probably just use aim high to take out their Tattered Haunter when they attack. Derek Potter Gandalf. Mixing your metaphors there. Aim high. The reason I'm doing It of the Horrid Swarm is because I've seen Borrowed Malevolence from my opponent, and this plays around that. Whereas, it doesn't play around Bounce, but they already use Just the Wind, whereas if I put it on a 1 toughness creature, that might not work out. Geist-Fueled Scarecrow. Sure. Not great when you're stuck on lands. Actually, I'm going to play the Cultist, because I want to sack that to Lashweed Lurker next turn. I'm actually in great shape here. Even though my opponent has the Scarecrow in play when they have not lots of lands, they don't have Borrowed Malevolence in their hand, by the way. They would have killed my Tattered Haunter as well. I like trading off there because it gives me a clue token. And then I can make a soldier. Oh, yeah. Those are some things. Right. And I get to keep killing my opponent with Tattered Haunter, which is nice. And let's Lashweed Lurker, sacking Exultant Cultist, paying 4, putting Gavni on Hallowed back on top. Draw a card, use the ability, Mysteries, and I'm just going to use Mysteries instead of Gnarlwood Dryad here, just because it's more mana efficient, and I'm not doing anything with the Dryad anyway. I think I'm in really good shape now. Like, I just have such good long-term plans with this Mysteries. Like, I'm just getting value. Yeah, this attack is fine. They can double block with Prized Amalgam Wailing Ghoul. But I get a token of Mysteries here. Oh, just Chump. That works too. And then Gnarwood Dryad, Watcher in the Web. And this actually does leave up Drownyard Behemoth off Lashweed Lurker if I really want to. Getting to the point, too, where I can just like, attack my opponent with everything. So they go to 4 off this, they block these 3, and they die, technically. So if they have no tricks, they're just dead. Really? What's going on? Alright, block. Block, and I guess block. I guess I don't get it. And we'll see what this means, but... Is what, a biting rain or something? A grotesque mutation. They just wanted to gain some life. Sure. So they do gain some life. I get some tokens. Opponent's on 12. So if I attack with everything, I need to not die to Midnight Scavengers, so actually let's just leave back all the tokens. Let's just attack with these two. And then play Geist of the Archives. No, I'll play Provisioner, because playing Provisioner means I get to use one clue and then still also play Drownyard Behemoth off Lashweed Lurker if I want to. This is looking good. I think this is my game to lose. Like, attacking with everything and have my opponent go land, Midnight Scavenger, meld onto Graph Rats would be a way to lose this. But I managed to avoid that, so that'll win the match and we get to go 3-0. Sweet! Yeah.